Oh, Benji, come take this from me. Benji, take this now, man. No, come in here. I've already told Jamaica I want them to see my floor manager. Thank you, Benji. Trying to save the environment.
All right.
And get everything on the techie side, you know, and in the cloud. And save the environment. This Always. Is Jordan Baskett next to me. My people, my people, my people. He is a tech guru who heads the first licensed Salesforce consultancy firm in the English-speaking Caribbean. CRMetry is the name of his company. He is the CEO. Jordan Baskett, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm good. This morning, we're looking at success stories. We're looking at people who can inspire, and I love a good story.
Yeah.
So I want to start with sharing with our viewers what CRMetry really does. I want you to take us through the customer relations management company, everything that you do, and why are you the only one in the Caribbean?
That's a great question. I think I might be the only one in the Caribbean because I see the opportunity for it here. I think a lot of times it's been passed over. And I think that relatively it's a great market, especially when you see what the BPO firms are trying to do around helping to build up the infrastructure, especially in Jamaica.
Right. But for those who don't really understand, I mean, I understand a little bit about
customer
relationship management.
Mm-hmm.
What is it?
So what is it? It's actually putting the customer at the center of your business so you can actually serve the customer better by understanding what they want, what their interaction history is with your company, so you can help them help themselves and give them a best customer experience that's possible.
How do you do it?
How do you do it? Well, we take a look at what the company's currently doing. We try to fix any issues they may have around, you know, putting the customer at the center of their business. And then once they put the customer at the center of their business, we help them to engage customers in ways that the customer, I guess I would say in the channel that the customer prefers to interact with them, whether it be like social media or it be through phone calls or it be through email. We help the company understand how what their customers really are and what they do.
All right, and I also read somewhere that most who invest in this kind of service like yours, CRMetry, I know Salesforce, that the ROI, the return on investment, for every dollar spent is $5.60. I read something like that.
It's a really high return, and it depends on how you're looking at your different key performance indicators. We see about at least a 30% return on investment just overall across the many different ways that you'd measure success.
All right. You said the word success. Let's get into your story so you can inspire. And doing extremely well across the Caribbean. Obviously a black man. Where you come from, you sound like you have a little accent. Not an accident, an accent. So let's sow the seeds of success
so
with our viewers.
I'm from Ann Arbor, Michigan, originally. I spent most of my professional career in New York.
And then how did you end up in Jamaica?
How did I end up in Jamaica? I have a Jamaican wife. So I started to, after, you know, the price of rent got really expensive in New York, and I really wanted to look at other places to live. Also, I love it here.
Yes.
It reminds me a lot of where I'm from, like the greater Detroit area.
Yes.
And I really, I mean, the people, the food, everything is great here.
So tell me now, growing up, your mom, you have an interesting story. You weren't the average child.
No. Some people call me a nerd in some respects, but I spent a lot of time, well, my mom went to business school when I was a young child, and actually I went with her. So I got exposure to a lot of different kinds of people and a lot of different facets of business, which piqued my interest. My mom spent a lot of time explaining business to me and breaking it down to a kid through a lot of stories around, you know, what business and decision makers had done and how they became successful. I remember one Christmas, you know, while other people were, we were actually in Florida, while everyone was at the beach, I was watching a documentary with her about Sears and the Sears Corporation.
Okay,
so
you knew business from an early age.
Always strived, and she's always put me as a child in environments where I could learn more about business and learn from business people, especially of representation. I think a lot of people don't have that in the States.
Share with our viewers, young people are watching. You know, we're an entrepreneur type community. Jamaica, we're an entrepreneur
very
city.
Much so.
Everybody has an idea. Everybody wants to go into business, and it's not easy. So I want you to share with us some of the most important lessons you've learned in your life and your journey.
And the most important lessons I've learned is always adapt to change. So, and always be trying to read the tea leaves of what businesses are doing. I think that's very big, and that's sort of how I got into what I am doing now. I saw that the world was changing, and I wanted to be a part of it. So rather always try to be a leader rather than a follower, because you will be rewarded for it.
All right.
Even in failure.
Ah, failure is a key indicator of what?
Success.
Ah, my brother, you're inspiring me today. Let's keep going. Tell me about your love for the stock market and what you learned while, you know, being around your mom and now you're in business.
Yeah.
What are stocks for those listening? And how are you, what do you know about stocks and how were you so interested in it?
I was interested in it because it was like, even as a child, it looked like buying a part of a company, mm-hmm. right? I didn't quite get all of it. So what my mom did, and I told my mom I was interested in stocks, she gave me a little bit of money to put in the stock market.
Yes.
Right? I told, it was a very small amount, and I told my broker I wanted to buy a car, and he laughed at me.
Yes.
But I was able to grow it about 300%, and I was able to buy a computer.
Look, so is your company great. On the stock market?
No, it is not.
No, but you're a private company.
Well, yeah, one day.
One day you could be listed.
Yeah, one day.
All right, mm-hmm. Well, you know Jamaica Stock Exchange. We have the best. One of the best in the
world. Yeah.
You know that, right?
Yeah, exactly.
There's a picture on the screen now of you and your wife. Is that your wife?
That's me and my mom.
Oh,
actually.
That's your mom. Okay, yeah. Sorry. No, yeah, because I just saw your wife and I'm like, why she look different there though?
There we go. Yeah, that's me and my wife.
I was waiting. Go. She's actually here in the studio.
Yeah.
Teamwork makes the dream work.
Always.
I'm all about that love story. I'm all about that marriage, mm-hmm. you know, that couple stuff. And I know she's right by your side.
Always.
Now, how'd you meet her and how involved is she in your success? This is important.
She's well, do you want to know how I met her first? Or
yeah, I want to know how you met her first.
I love
a good story. Yeah.
So I met her when I lived in New York.
Uh-huh.
I met her on Tinder. So like the dating app. When it first came out.
It works?
It worked for me.
To all my girlfriends out there struggling, it works. That's when it first came out, and it was good them time.
Yeah, yeah.
So you met her, and then how'd you all meet up, and then?
Well, we talked for a very long time, because she seemed like, for me, I don't want to sound cheesy, but she seemed too perfect.
Oh.
So we talked for a while, mm-hmm. and then we one day said, you know, let's meet.
Yeah.
So then we met, and we had a wonderful date.
I won't get into all of that. Well, but she's Jamaican.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then you just decided, was this the first time? You have Jamaican roots?
No, I do not.
Oh, so she was the one who really brought you home.
Well, she was traveling to Jamaica so much for business. Mm-hmm. I thought, you know, let me see what this is all about. And mm-hmm. I came and I loved it.
Mm-hmm.
So from the moment I, you know, first came, and that was about 4 or 5 years ago, I said, I want to move here. And she's like, well, what are you going to do? And I was like, I don't know. I'll figure it out. Yeah. But I'm going to be here.
And now you have CRM Mystery.
Yeah.
You're leading the Caribbean for customer relationship management.
Yeah.
And tell me about her contribution now to the company. How does she help to grow your company?
Well, she's the head of business development.
I just wanted to put it out there.
Yeah, she helps in everything.
Yes.
She's a sounding board for mm-hmm. the ideas that we have.
Mm-hmm.
She is helping grow relationships with clients.
Mm-hmm.
She's helping like in a lot of the marketing and strategic placement that we're looking for.
Right.
I mean, she's
everything.
Yeah, she's a lot of things.
Make me cry, Mr. Baskett. I love them story, I don't know. But going back into the business, how mm-hmm. can our viewers contact you and support you and help you to keep being a success story?
Well, I mean, if they want to know more about, you know, customer relationship management tools, mm-hmm. they can reach out to me at, you know, our website, mm-hmm. crmetry.com.
That's CRMET or CRMME?
E. CRMM.
M, yes.
E-T.
E-T-R-Y.
.com. Exactly.
Yes. CEO, let's grow our companies together. Let's have the best customer relationship management. You know, it just makes life easier.
And it's for the customers especially, because mm-hmm. when your customers know that you care about them, they care about you more.
Yeah. And I care about my customers, my viewers.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why we're bringing you this story, to inspire you mm-hmm. and let you know that anything is possible for anybody. CRMetry's CEO, Officer Jordan Baskett. I love a good story. Big up your wife. You never say her name.
Oh, Andrea Johnson is
Andrea
her name.
Andrea Johnson, Queen Johnson. All right, my people.